Hello everyone, this is EC251. The subject name is Introduction to Electronics. Now today we'll do about BJT. Now for the transistor construction, it can be either PNP or NPN type, but we can see the base, if we see, it is about 0.001 inch and the total is about 0.150 inch. PNP, NPN, this is the two type, and emitter base collector is the three terminal of this. Next, transistor operation. In transistor operation, the starting point is emitter. Okay, so we give two external sources. Emitter bias is called VEE and VCC is the collector bias. So first junction we do forward bias, so it is PNP. So in case of P, we give the positive terminal so that it gives forward bias, and the second terminal is reverse bias, so the second terminal is P, so here we give negative terminal so that it is become negative, I mean reverse bias. So the emitter base junction first is forward bias, the emitter collector junction the second is reverse bias, and we see this is the charge flow from emitter. The majority of charge portion, majority charge goes, as it is forward bias, it goes to this side. In the base, this length is more, this length is small, so maximum goes to collector and it is attracted to the collector, and small portion goes to base. So small current goes to base, maximum current goes to collector, maximum charge particle goes to collector. And we can see, as first junction is forward bias, the depletion region is very less, and second is very high because it is reverse bias. Now this is a NPN transistor. Previously we see this PNP transistor, now it is a NPN transistor, so we can see that the arrow is reverse bias, arrow is in the opposite direction of the previous. Here it was from emitter to collector, because we take the whole current as the direction of current. Now this is NPN, so majority charge here at emitter is electron, so it is in opposite direction, so it coming from here to here, and small base current. And like previous case, here also emitter current is the sum of the collector and base current, and base current is very small, so it is almost equal to emitter current, almost equal to collector current, and the collector current also having two currents, majority and minority. Majority is the maximum and minority is when the other terminal means at collector, if you say opposite terminal, that is emitter. If emitter is open, that means majority charge carrier cannot go to base and collector, then whatever for only the reverse bias of collector, this is collector current. Now if we want to make two terminal two port network has two input port, two output port, but BJT has only three terminal, so for BJT we need to take four terminal, we need to make one terminal common for both input as well as output. Now so one by one we will do common. Base common is the first, then we can do common emitter or common collector. This is common base configuration, so we can see base is common for PNP as well as NPN transistor. It is grounded. Emitter is the input port and collector is the output port. And the arrow is according to the direction of current flow. In case of PNP, emitter is inside, base and collector is outside, and opposite for NPN. This is the symbol of the diode. Symbol of the BJT. BJT can it can be considered that BJT is made for two diode. That is two PN junction together is a BJT. So this is the symbol of BJT, and these two direction of arrow is given as per the biasing. In this case, emitter current is going in the side, so it is the arrow. And in this case of emitter, current is coming outside from emitter. So it is, you can see the arrow is outside. So that is the flow of current is given by the arrow. The base is common to both input, that is emitter base, and output collector base of the transistor. So emitter base is input terminal, collector base is the output terminal. This is the input characteristics. It is almost similar to diode characteristics, diode forward bias characteristics. So we can see that it is almost equal to diode characteristics. Only the thing is connected to base biasing, that is the output voltage we take as a parameter. So input current is IE and input voltage is VBE. This is the gap between these two. And if output voltage is more, we can see 1, 10, 20. So if output voltage is more, output voltage is used to attract the majority charge carrier which is generated from emitter. So if output voltage is more, more current we will get. So you can see the curve is more closer to y axis, that is more current we are having if output voltage we take more. This is the output characteristics. So output characteristics, we have output voltage by output current. So this is output voltage, this is the output current. Output voltage is VCV, output current is IC. Here we take input current as a parameter. So input current is emitter current. So there are various lines for different input current. For I equal to 0 milliampere, we can see below this, that is below any emitter current, whatever is that, that is the below of this point, that is considered as just a minute. The below 0 ampere is considered as cutoff region, and you see this is the 0 point, so this point is negative, and so it is going up, then parallel to x-axis up, parallel to x-axis up, parallel to x-axis, at which point the slope is changing, that point and left to that is said saturation region. And in the saturation region, we can see it is both the junction is in forward bias, because this is the output voltage, and output voltage is we taking reverse bias. Now it is before 0, so that means it is forward bias. So both forward bias in saturation region, and for cutoff region, both will be in reverse bias. Both the junction will be reverse bias. So again that three operating region, active, that is normal, or we say what, the this region generally where we do the operation, that is both, I mean first junction is forward bias, second junction is reverse bias. So base emitter, that is the first junction, collector base is the second junction. For active, it is forward reversed. For cutoff, both are reversed. For saturation, we just see it is both forward. Active is the operating region of the amplifier. Cutoff is the amplifier is basically off because both are reversed bias. There is voltage but very little current. Saturation, the amplifier is full on, there is current but very little voltage. So this is the cutoff and saturation. For cutoff, there is voltage. We have voltage in cutoff, but the current is very little. In case of saturation, there is current, but the voltage is very, very little. Coming to next, as the base current is very, very small, we say almost collector current is equal to emitter current. And for silicon, base emitter voltage, that is the first junction, we keep it in forward bias. So that is the equivalent to forward PN junction, that is a diode. For silicon it is 0.7 volt in forward bias. So BVE we take as 0.7 volt. Now we know that BJT is a current control device, that means with the value of base current we can determine the other two current, that is collector current and emitter current. So we have to know what is the ratio from base current. Now the first one is alpha, that is the ratio between collector current to emitter current. So and as both are same, it is almost equal to 1 and the range is 0.9 to 0.998. And we know that so alpha C equal to IC current, that is collector current, is equal to alpha times of emitter current plus the current of collector to base when emitter is open. You see the there are three ICB, that is in between these two, whatever the current is flowing between base and collector, that is the second junction. O means when the another junction is open, this means emitter is open. So that is the O, means emitter is open. So when emitter is open, that time whatever the current is flowing, that is ICBO. And for AC mode, this is the change in IC by change in IE when VC, that is collector to base voltage, that is the second junction voltage, is equal to constant. That time whatever the value, that we say in alpha AC. Next, transistor amplification. Suppose input resistance is 20 ohm, output resistance is 100 kilo ohm, because first junction is forward bias, so it is in range of ohm, and second junction is reverse bias, so it is kilo ohm. 200 millivolt voltage is applied in the input. So input current is equal to input voltage by input resistance. So it is 200 millivolt divided by 20 ohms, it is 10 milliampere. Now if we consider the emitter current and collector current almost same, then this current is also 10 milliampere. So same collector current is flowing to the load, so load current is also 10 milliampere. Now output voltage, that is output current multiplied by output resistance, that is the load resistance at this point. So it is multiplied, so it is given 5 kilo ohm. So 5 kilo ohm multiplied by 10 milliampere, so it is 50 volt. So our input was 200 millivolt, output is 50 volt. So output voltage, that is load voltage divided by input voltage, that is voltage, how much is increased, that is the amplification of voltage, this is 250. So we can see in transistor 250 times voltage gain is there. So it is a huge. Coming to next is common emitter configuration. So emitter is here, so we write the emitter at the bottom so that we can take it to the both side, that is in the input side as well as output side. So emitter is here, it is common to both input and output. So at this case, base terminal is input terminal, collector terminal is output terminal, and first junction is forward biased, that is this one. Second junction, it is N, so we are giving a positive because it is a reverse bias. Emitter is common to both input, that is base emitter, and output, that is collector emitter. The input is on the base and output is on the collector, and this is the symbol taking the current as the direction of the current arrow. Arrow is given like that. This is common emitter characteristics. So in this case we can see three difference. First one is when input current, and in this case the input current is base current, because emitter is common to both, so input terminal is base terminal. So whenever input current is zero, previous time, that is in case of common base configuration, it was x axis, current is little bit up. So cutoff region is this one. So it has little bit up from this axis. That is the difference, number one. Number two difference is, you can see these curves are not parallel to this line. And number three difference is, as you see, the slope is more in the upper side, it is not constant. And another difference also you can see, that is previous time it was negative, now you see these points, it is, this is zero, so it is positive. So this is also one difference. And just let us see the previous characteristics. You see, it is 0, 5, 10, 15, 20. It is one in volt. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It is in milliampere, common base. Now, common emitter, it is again 0, 5, 10, 15, 20 like that. That is 0 to 3, 4, 5, 7 milliampere. So same type of, we can say the scaling, it is in milliampere IC, and in this case it is in milliampere. It is also IC because output terminal is not changed, input terminal is changed in this case. So for the same scale, we can have this kind of differences. And this is the input characteristics. Input characteristics, you see it is in volt, 0.4, 0.2, 0.4, 0.6, 0.8, 1.0. And you see at this case, it is the output, this is the input characteristics. Okay, so input is base. So base current, it is given in microampere. But in the previous case, what we have seen, it is in milliampere. So that is another difference. In case of common base configuration, this axis was in milliampere, because that time input current was taken into emitter current. Emitter current was the input current. This time base current is the input current, so it is in microampere. That is one difference. Another difference we can see is 20-10-1. So as the voltage is increased, it is going away from this axis. Previous time it was close to this axis. The reason was, this is the output voltage. Output voltage is reverse biased to attract the charged particles, majority charged particles, which is generated from emitter, so that minimum current can go to base, maximum current comes to emitter. That is our aim. Now if we increase output voltage, that means base current will be minimized. Now in this case it is common emitter, so it is the base current which is input terminal. So base is the input terminal, so base current is the input current. So if we increase the collector voltage, base current will reduce. So that is the previous case, the emitter was input terminal. So if that time collector voltage is increased, emitter voltage will increase, and this is base current, so base current will decrease. So that is the difference between these two. Common emitter amplify current. So ideal is emitter current equal to collector current plus base current. As we can see in the this is incoming, this is outgoing. So that means this have to be this plus this. So for common emitter, emitter current is collector current plus base current, and we see IC equal to alpha times IE, and actual current is IC equal to alpha E plus ICBO, where ICBO equal to minority collector current. ICBO is usually so small that it can be ignored, except the high power transistor and in high temperature environment. Otherwise we can ignore it. It is collector to base current when emitter is open. O means open, the other terminal which is not given E. So emitter is open, that time it is ICBO. When IB equal to 0 microampere, that means base current equal to 0, that is the input current equal to 0. That time the transistor is in cutoff, but there is some minority current flowing called ICEO. Okay, so ICEO is actually ICBO divided by 1 minus alpha. This is the expression for ICBO. ICO equal to ICBO by 1 minus alpha. when emitter current is 0 microampere, that is emitter current has not started, it is off. Okay, coming to next, base current equal to 0 microampere. It is written IB equal to 0 microampere. It is not visible, that's why I have written it here again. Base current is 0 microampere, that is the condition. Next, we coming to the next ratio, that is called beta. Beta represents the amplification factor of a transistor. Beta is sometimes referred to as HFE, a term used in transistor modeling calculation. Now in DC mode, beta is the ratio between collector and base current, that is IC by IB. And AC mode, we can see it is the range change in IC by change in IB when VC equal to constant. Next, if we determine the value of beta from a graph, this is the actual graph of a transistor. We are taking the points. So from here we are actually calculating. So beta AC. So delta IC, that is collector current change, you have to see. So collector current is taken at this 2 point, and whatever the values are given here, and it is divided by delta IB. So the graph is the base current values in between. So at this 2 point, it is this is a 29 microampere base current, and this is 30. So 30 minus 20, it was the change in base current. When VC is constant, so we see VCC we are not changing. At the same point we are taking. So at the same point, it is cutting at 2 point. These two values we are taking, and for which values are there, that is we are taking the base current. So the difference we can see, for VC equal to 7.5 volt, it is 100. And beta DC, if we take only single point, so it is 108. Both beta values are usually reasonably close and are often used interchangeably. We can do interchange. One is 100, one is 108. So both are, we can interchange them because both are almost same, there is no very much difference is there. The relationship between the two factors beta and alpha, alpha is beta by beta plus 1 and beta is alpha by alpha minus 1. So to convert to alpha, all are plus, but to convert to beta it is alpha by alpha minus 1. Relationship between currents, collector current is beta times of base current, emitter current is beta plus 1 times of base current. So collector current is beta times IB, okay, plus another IB. If we add, this is emitter current. So emitter current is, you see, little bit more or one base current more. Now on collector configuration, so collector will takes at the bottom so that we can take it comma to the both input and output, both for PNP and NPN. It is given, the direction of arrow is given as per the flow of current. In this case, as this is collector is common to both, we take the other terminal as input and output. So for input, the base terminal is taken and emitter is taken as the output terminal. This is the symbol. And the direction of current is taken as per the arrow generated by the biasing of the circuit. This is the characteristics, output characteristics. So we can see that the characteristics are similar to those of the common emitter configuration, except the vertical axis is IP. Previous time it was not I, this time this is I, but the configuration of graph we can see it is very unsimilar. Operating limits of this configuration, so obviously we has a maximum limit. VCE is at maximum and IC is at minimum, so that is the cutoff region. IC is at maximum and VCE is at minimum, that is the saturation region. Transistor operates in the active region between saturation and cutoff, and this is the maximum power, that is particular transistor has a power rating, so we have to operate below that, otherwise it will burn. So that is the for power rating we are limiting up to this, and this side limit is cut off, this side limit is saturation. In between these points we can operate in active region. For common base, power distribution is VCB into IC. For common emitter, it is VCE into IC. For common collector, it is VC into IE. So power is voltage multiplied by current. In each case, we can see transistor specification sheet. So here all these values are given so that we can know more about the transistor. It continues, each and every detail is given. We can see. This is how we can identify the terminal for this type of. It is, if you see clockwise, emitter collector base. In this case of configuration, the case is collector, and this kind of configuration from the node. Clockwise it is the emitter base collector. If this is the collector and both side is emitter base, and this is different configuration is there, that this type hook is collector, this is base and this is emitter, and this is first one emitter, second is base closely, and the rest at the far is collector. So and here we can see the white dot, so both are collector and emitter as per the from the white dot we can configure it. We can see what is the terminal. Now biasing, what is called biasing? The DC voltage applied to a transistor in order to turn it on so that it can amplify the AC signal is called biasing. So VBE we know it is 0.7 volt, so IE equal to beta plus 1 times of IB, it's almost equal to collector current, that means collector current equal to beta times IB. If input is given to a transistor, we can see cut off input signal, so we have to be specific. So that we can avoid the cut off region. It is the suppose load line. It is given, so this and this is cut off as per the input signal is out of this point. Okay, so that we have to be conscious, because if input signal is like this and these two point, this is apart from that. Okay, so this we have to be special, we have to be cautious about this. Operating point, this DC input establishes at an operating or quotient point called the Q point. So the void region, this is the emitter region or active region where we will do the our operation. This is cut off, this is saturation, this is the over power, it is above the power rating. So and we know that we take one load line, it is something like this. So while load line and that characteristics are cut, it is called Q point. So at a time we can operate at one Q point, and we have to determine so that it does not go to these three regions that we have to be process. Active or linear region operation, that is limited junction is forward bias, corrected junction is reverse bias, both with respect to base. Cutoff region operation, that is base limited junction is reverse bias, and saturation region operation, base limited junction and base corrected junction both is forward biased. We can see normal operation, first junction is forward, second bias junction is reverse. Cut off, both the junction have to be in reverse bias. Saturation, both the junction has to be in forward biased. We can have four type of DC biasing circuit: fixed bias circuit, emitter stabilized bias circuit, collector emitter loop, voltage divider bias circuit, and DC bias with voltage feedback. So this is the five type of DC biasing circuit. Now starting with the first one, that is fixed bias circuit. Fixed bias circuit, VCC, only these two resistance we are using, and we can see this is connected to base, so this is RB, base resistance. This is connected to collector, so this is RC, collector resistance, and these two capacitor is given in input and output. Okay, next if you take only base emitter loop, that means only base point and emitter point, if we consider, now just see, this is the VCC, so we can assume this is the positive terminal, and negative terminal is not given here, but if we use a battery, the negative terminal is, in this case it is a positive voltage, so the negative terminal will be given to ground, and if it is given to ground, this point and this point both are ground, so we can assume this in loop, because this the negative polarity and this ground is same, so these two points we can take together, and this is, you see, this is it, negative point is grounded and this one. Now in this case we use KVL, so VCC minus IVRB minus VB is equal to 0, or solving from the base current, IB equal to VCC minus VB by RB. From this equation we can take the value of base current, and if you take the another loop, that is collector emitter loop, collector current is beta times of base current, so from KVL we can write VCE equal to ICRC. VC is this ground, so VC is this point, and you see this is also ground, this is VCC, and this is the voltage drop ICRC. So VC minus ICRC will be this point, that is equal to VCE. Saturation, when the transistor is operating in saturation, current through the transistor is at its maximum possible value, that is IC saturation equal to VCC by RC. When VC is almost equal to 0 volt, the approximation is equivalent to move the region below VCE saturation of the output curves to align on the output current axis. Next, load line analysis. The endpoints of the load line are IC saturation, that is current equal to voltage by resistance VC by RC, and at this point VC is equal to 0 volt and VC cutoff, so VC equal to VCC and IC equal to 0 milliampere. Now the Q point of the operating point for the values of RB sets the value of IB, that sets the values of VCE and IC, that is depending on this resistance, base resistance, base current is fixed, and if base current is fixed, VCE and IC is also fixed. If we take in VCC 1 greater than VCC 2 greater than VCC 3, so from 1 to 2 to 2 to 3, if we are minimizing the VCC value, that means this point, this point, this point, so obviously this is the point, so Q point is moved at the arrow, that is this is the direction. If we changing only the resistance, that is from 1 to 2, 2 to 3, if we are decreasing the resistance, increasing the resistance, R2 is greater than R1, R3 is greater than R2, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, if we are increasing the resistance, so resistance if we are increasing, so you can see this point is, come to this point, to this point, so again it is this side Q point, and if we are increasing the current, so obviously from this to this to this, Q point is moved along the load line. Next, emitter stabilized bias current, bias circuit, so we can see this resistance is there which was not in the previous case. We can see previous case fixed by circuit was this one. Only two resistance was there. Here it was no resistance is there. Now we are adding one other resistance at emitter circuit which was not at the previous. So from fixed bias it comes to emitter stabilized bias circuit. First base emitter loop BC, so 1, 2, 3, 4 is 4 value we take. We take I equal to the plus 1 into IB and solving for IB it is VC minus VB by RB plus beta plus 1 into RE. And for collector emitter loop 1, 2, 3, 4 voltage drop is there. So again we have to take all the 4. I almost equal to IC, we can write this one. So also we can write VE emitter voltage is equal to IERE. This is down. So IERE is this point. So VC equal to VC plus VE, that is equal to VC minus ICRC. VB equal to VCC minus IRBR, that is equal to VBE. VC minus IRRB, that is equal to VBE plus VE. Improved bias stability. So what is stability? Stability refers to circuit condition in which the currents and voltages will remain fairly constant over a wide range of temperature and transistor beta values. Adding RE to the emitter improves the stability of a transistor. How? For fixed bias circuit, we have been done this current equation for IB is equal to VCC minus VB by RB. At this case it is VC minus VB is divided by RB plus beta plus 1 into RE. IC equal to beta into IB. So IB in fixed bias circuit cannot change. So change in beta results in large change in output current and voltage. There is a difference between these two equations. Value of base current is given here and current current is just beta times of base current. That means in fixed bias circuit IB cannot change. So value of beta can change in output current and voltage, large change. Okay, so that is the difference between these two. By taking just one additional resistance we improve the bias stability. From the equation it is, we can see saturation level, the endpoints can be determined from the load line. VC cutoff, VC equal to VCC, IC equal to 0 milliampere, and IC saturation, VC equal to 0 volt and IC equal to VCC by RC plus RE. So VC by RC plus RE and VC, the load line is drawn. Next is voltage divided bias. So was not here. So we can, this is the most stable, is very stable by a circuit. We are using 4 resistance which was not up to now. The currents and voltages are nearly independent of any variation in beta. That's why it is very stable biasing circuit. Next, it is how we are analyzing this one. If IB is very very greater than I1 and I1 and I2 is almost same, so this is the 1, this is the 2. VB equal to R2 VCC by R1 plus R2, or VI greater than 10 times of R2, we can write I equal to V by I and V equal to VB minus VBE. So Kirchhoff's voltage law, we can directly write VC equal to VCC minus ICRC minus IERE, taking emitter and collector current almost equal, and VC equal to VCC minus IC into RC plus IE. Next, voltage divider bias analysis for transistor saturation level, IC sat equal to IC max, that is equal to VCC by RC by plus IE, and load time analysis for cutoff, VC equal to VCC and IC equal to 0 milliampere. For saturation, IC equal to VCC by RC plus RE, where VC equal to 0 volt. And putting all these values, if any numerical is given, we can simply solve it by putting all the values like given in this example. Here also same thing is done by exact calculation, so all the exact values are taken and the calculation has been done. DC bias with voltage feedback, another way to improve the stability of a bias circuit is to add a feedback path from collector to base. In this bias circuit, the Q point is only slightly dependent on the transistor beta. This is the DC bias voltage feedback. So we can see this point is connected by a resistance. This two resistance is there as it is. So again, base emitter loop is from Kirchhoff's law, we can solve it. And if we assume beta current is much much less than collector current, so this we can write, and IC equal to beta times IB, and I equal to almost equal to IC, so we can write this one, and solving from IB, this is the final equation for base current. And similarly from collector emitter loop also, we can solve for VCE in the same manner. And for saturation level, cutoff saturation, in the same manner we can write the equations. And for transistor switching network, transistor with only the DC source applied can be used as electronic switch, that is on or off. Switching circuit calculation, IC sat equal to VCC by RC, IB is greater than IC sat by beta DC, it is for to ensure saturation. Intercollector resistance and saturation at saturation and cutoff is these two correspondingly. Is the switching time, that is uptime, downtime, and this is the transistor on, transistor off time, so that we can say. So this is the troubleshooting hints. Is 0.7 volt VVE. VCE is 20% to 70% of VCC. Test for open sand, shorts with ohmmeter. Test the solder joint. Test the transistor with a transistor tester or a car pressure. Note that the load of the next stage affects the transistor operation. So this we have to check. PNP transistor bypassing circuit is the same, that is NPN. The only difference is the current are flowing in the opposite direction. So this is the end of chapter 3 and chapter 4 of Worsted textbook. Thank you.